Hello and welcome to Planet Country with Big Stu and MJ. Here's a moment you may have missed from the last show.
Lay a blanket on the ground, kissing in the crickets is the only sound. We out of town.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Girl, you gotta get down with us.
Keith Urban is currently in Australia with his Fuse World Tour. He's already played Townsville and Brisbane and hit Sydney next before Melbourne, Perth and the New South Wales regional town of Narrabri. Keith has regularly toured Australia as his star has risen not just in America but around the world. In some ways, Australia was late to the party with Keith. Country fans followed his career, but it's only been in recent years that he's crossed over into the mainstream in Australia. His last tour here sold more than one show in Sydney and Melbourne for the first time. Now with the Fuse Tour, he has again booked multiple dates at the country's largest indoor arenas. It seems finally Keith is being recognised for his immense talent.
I think the coaching on The Voice has a lot to do with that. And he's now one of those artists who can pretty much dictate where his career is going to go next. He can make whatever album he wants. He's risen above the constraints and the industry puts on artists.
Yeah, you're right. And the amazing thing is he's done it his way. It would have been easy for Keith to turn up in Nashville in the early 90s and do what they told him, you know, stick a 10-gallon hat on his head and sing formulaic country songs. But to his credit, he didn't. People like John Williamson say Keith Urban sold out by going to America, but they don't get it. A cowboy hat, that would have been selling out. What Keith Urban did was reinvent country. He broke down labels and stereotypes and brought the whole genre forward.
And now with his Fuse album, he is experimenting with new sounds and worked with producers from the rock and pop world to create songs that continue to push the boundaries of country, but somehow still remain typically Keith Urban sounding.
Well, we're in for a treat tonight on Planet Country because Keith has opened up about some of the songs on Fuse and the inspiration behind them.
In some ways, I would say that the record was almost, it started to become a reflection of the gigs that I've played over the years. It was almost like a song like Lost Poster Child is just it's shag pile carpeted, raw, trashy, beer-soaked juke joint song. That's what it is. So we just left it really rough.
Go on.
And then another song like Somewhere in My Car is a bit more refined and a bit more like the arenas with the big production and everything. So that's that kind of song.
I'm driving home tonight, catching all red lights. That's alright, cause I don't want to be alone. There's nobody waiting there, cold and empty bed. Words I wish I'd said, come on the radio.
And then there's intimate things like like come back to me that are a bit more like the theatres that we played in between. So the songs to me almost feel like the different kind of places that we've played over the years and still do.
If the sand that you ain't wrote your name in, if you're tired of the view from the same window, if there's lips that you wanna get drunk on, Ferris wheels that you need to get stuck on, go see everything you think you need to see, then come back to me.
It's all energy, it's all motion. I mean, all music is energy. That's what it is, even really, really slow songs. It's the energy that pulls you in, pulls me in. And if the energy's not there, I don't get pulled in. Doesn't matter what's being said, doesn't matter how pretty the melody is. And I think when that energy's there, it defies everything. It defies the quality of the sound recording and all that. It doesn't matter. You know, it's funny, people, we talk so much about the quality, MP3 versus analog versus this versus digital, blah, 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 blah. But the reality is, man, when you can hear a song on the crappiest broken car stereo when the station is not even on right, and you go, oh man, I love this song. So it's apparently not the sound. There's something else going on. It's the spirit and the energy of the song that grabs you.